we are printing the values from 1 to 10. Okay, so we have seen this example in the last session, and when you execute this line of code, you will say writing done, and open text.txt file to see the output. Okay, so here this file is present. This file is present inside the content, and here you can double click and you will see the output is shown starting from 1 to 10. Okay, so you can take the range of 3 to 30 and you can see the output right here. Okay, you can see the output right here. You can change the range to 3 to 30, and you will execute this line of code, and you can double click on this text file. So you will see first value is stored as 3 up to 29, and minus 1 value it will store. Okay, so if you contain this value to 31, if you use the value 31 and minus 1 value it will take. So you can see, after double clicking on this text.txt file, you can see right now total 30 entries right now made inside this text.txt file. Clear? First value is not given right now because the range is started from 31. Okay. 31 to 1. So this is not shown right here. It is not showing the value. First index start from the 31, but in our text.txt, the first index is starting from the first value. Okay, here in this line of code, let's understand this. First, we are using the try operation, and it will check this particular text.txt file. So this open is used to open the file. Okay. So if this particular file is present, so it will read this file. Okay, it will read this file. Then it will execute the for loop. If this file is not present, then this control directly go to the except statement. Clear, everyone? So what it will check, we are using the for loop for line in FP. Okay, so what is FP? FP is this file. Okay, FP is this file. So this is your file. Every line start from the first, second, third, fourth in this manner. Okay, so this line will be checked right here. There is try and exception. Finally block is used in the switch case. Okay, in the switch case, so you have to define the case one. Okay, inside this case you have to give the statement. Okay, if this statement, then you have to define the case number two, and then you give the statement. So finally is given in after this particular case statements. If these cases are not present, then finally block will be executed. Clear? So but in this for loop we are using the value starting from this variable. Okay, we have started this line variable, and we are checking this variable inside this particular file. So these values are given right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to so on, and it will print that particular line. Okay, so it will show the fp.close. So it will close that particular file. And if that particular file is not present, it automatically shows the message that this file is not present inside this particular library. Okay, or you can say inside this particular working environment. Okay. So what is showing, you can see right here, text.txt contain the value 1 to 10. Okay, so what it is showing, so it will read that particular file, and it will read from this first line, and it will print the first line as it is, and then for loop continue until it reaches up to the last point. Okay, so this fp contain the last value 10, and this fp contain the first value as 1. Okay, so firstly it will start from the first location, and it will print each and every value through this print function. Okay, through this print function. So firstly it will show the output as 1, then it will show the output as 2, and in such a manner it will show all the outputs. Okay, what do you mean by append? Append means you have to add something on that particular file. Okay, in this file we have already 1 to 10 values. If you want to add something more inside this particular file, then how you can add these values inside this particular file? Okay, so what we are doing right here, firstly we will use the try block right here, and we will check the file is present or not. Okay, so first file we have used the variable as readfp, that means it will read the file. Second variable we are using right here for the write operation, so it will write inside that file. So what it will do, it will write inside the result file. And where it read? It read from the text.txt file. Okay, so anything inside this text.txt file is written. Let's suppose that these are the values which are written inside this text.txt. All these values to be written inside this result.txt. Okay, so what we are doing right here, we are calling the for loop. Okay, we are using this for loop. We are initializing some variable line. Okay, and we will check this readfp file. Okay, so this readfp file will be checked. Okay, so what this readfp file contain? It contain all the values starting from this one location to the last location. Okay, so what it is doing right here, it will use this file writefp. Okay, so this writefp variable is used right here, and we are calling the function. Okay, we are calling the write function. So what it will do, it will print the line. Okay, it will print the line. So initially this one value is present inside this line. Okay, so this line value will be printed right, or will be written inside this particular write file. Okay, and what it is doing right here, it is opening the file result.txt in a read mode, and it will give this for loop. It will read the variable line inside this fp, and it will print all the lines as it is, and it will close the file. Okay, then we are using the error message, no such file is existing inside this particular block, and we will use this readfp to close the file and writefp to close the file. And lastly we will print the warning message, so this open result.txt is not present right here. Inside this result.txt we have initial value up to 6, and from 7th onward it will store all the values. How to create a file? We have discussed this thing. So you can create the file with the help of this variable. So this is the variable name, and inside this variable name what we are opening, this xyz1.txt file. Okay, and we are using the variable name writefp and we will close the file and we will print done operation. If this file is not present, so exception will generate and it will give message that file already exists. Clear? So let's execute this line of code right from here, and you will see the message done will appear. Okay, so this xyz 1.txt will be created inside your library. Okay, you can see right here, this is xyz1.txt file. So when you double click on it, you will see that. So let's understand this code first. When you want to access your software or operating system, you have to import your operating system. So OS stands for your operating system, and all files right here is a variable. OS is a object for the complete operating system, and inside this operating system we will list the directories. Okay, we will list the directory. So what do you mean by directories? This is your DT class. Okay, inside this DT we have divided the course content in separate. So this DT class is having unit number 1. Okay, it is having unit number 2, it is having unit number 3 and unit number 4. Okay, so this DT is a main directory. This is a main directory, and these are the subdirectories. Yes, directory stand for the collections of files inside a particular folder. Okay, so when you collect different files in one folder, that is called a directory. So we will print all the files. Those will be presented inside this particular directory. They will be printed for data. So in such a manner, all the directories will be shown right here using the print function. Okay, .txt and your xyz1.txt. So all the files are present inside this content folder. Okay, so this is called a working directory. So how to get this working directory? First, you need to import the operating system. Then you have to use the object os.getcwd. So this getcwd. Okay, cwd stand for your working current. C stand for current, working, D stand for directory. D stand for working directory. Okay, so cwd is a function. With the help of this function, you can you can call the particular library, and that will be stored inside this current driver name. Okay, and you can print this current directory name. So you can see right here, the current directory name is. So we will discuss how to delete a file. So if you want to delete a file, what you will do? Firstly, you will import the operating system. You will use this try block and you will check this file. Okay, same thing is happening right here. If this file is present, then you can move toward this side. If this file is not present, then you can move to the except statement. This is try, okay, and this is your except statement. Okay, so if this file is present, okay, then you can move to this side and you can perform the task, okay, and give the output. If this file is not present, directly move to the except statements and print the statement and give the output. Okay, so what it will check? It will check first this xyz1.txt file, and we are using a remove function. Okay, so this remove is a function. It will remove the file which is specified inside this particular double inverted comma. Okay, so it will check your operating system first. If this file is present, it will remove it. Then it will print the statement file deleted. If this file is not present, then automatically this statement execute, print error message file not found. Clear everyone? So let's execute this line of code and understand how we can delete this particular file. Let's suppose that initially you can double click on it and you will see there is nothing present right here inside this text xyz.1.txt file, and you want to delete this particular file. Okay, so execute it, file deleted. Okay, so you can see right here on the left hand side this xyz1.txt file is not present. Now I am again changing the name. Right here we have one another file abc.txt file. Okay, so I am again deleting this particular file abc, file deleted. Okay, so you can check on the right hand side. Okay, in the content this file is present or not. abc.txt is not present right here. If I will again execute this line of code, you will see error message is appearing, file not found.